We go.
Go.
It's recording. Hello. Welcome to episode 50 of The 6-Inch Show. I cannot believe this is 50 episodes we've done. July 2016, I think we started this. 17? 7 must have been 7.
17, yeah.
17. Jeez, been a long time. I'm Fly Guy. This is Matt. By now, episode 50, you should know the drill, but if not, this show is all about 6-inch figures. Lots of cool little action figures that we love. Tonight is a bit of a special episode. We're going to go through our top 10 of 2019, both Star Wars The Black Series and Marvel Legends. You'll get my top 10 of both and Matt's top 10 of both. We've got some news as well to reveal, and we'll do all the toy photography stuff we normally do. In episode 51, where we're going to go over some of the top toy photography, which you do not want to miss, of Marvel Legends and Star Wars The Black Series. That's episode 51, which we'll bring to you as our Christmas special. I think we should get drunk when we do that episode. That'd be good. You're really tipsy and drunk and have some fun. Anyway, episode 50 of this show. So thanks to everyone who's watched so far, and thank you to all the comments on episode 49. Just to have a little look at what was said, you guys said the last time. My God, it's been so long, I can't remember how to share my desktop. There we go. And what did you guys say? Let's have a look. So episode 49, what did we get? People were saying 28 comments. A lot of people were talking about the Heavy Mandalorian, which came out just at the time we did that show. And it really arrived quick. You and I both got ours like incredibly quickly after they announced it, which was really nice. That was one of the most timely releases I've ever seen, from when they announced it to boom, in the shops in like 3 or 4 days.
So I'd also say that it was incredibly well-guarded secret.
It was, wasn't it?
It kind of didn't leak, and it also kind of showed what a missed opportunity Baby Yoda was for them, because if you're protecting it all for one episode, I was thinking about it. How do they disguise Baby Yoda without it leaking? You just say that it's a Yoda figure. Nobody knew that it existed. Nobody knew, or was that going to be able to, you know, recode it? It would have been, oh, there's another Yoda figure coming? And you just call it Yoda as its code name, and nobody would have got it.
I get the absolute feeling that not a living soul knew that Baby Yoda existed. The way the toy companies reacted, they're all really fast prototype-looking stuff. So I think they really, really kept it under wraps, quite rightly so. But Brian B was saying he got his really quickly from Best Buy. He was in the US. And IG-11, the price, which some of us know, dropped way too quickly. But then again, it is a pretty, pretty crappy figure. It's really not that great. You kind of agree, IG-11?
Yeah.
It's just not,
there's not much to it. And
it's fallen over in my shelf, even on a stand consistently. So anyway, Dale Thomas, Black Series Jedi Knight Luke Redux is amazing, full stop. I agree. I think it's a pretty damn good figure. Might even appear in the top 10s tonight. Thank you, the Battlestar, on the congratulations of us reaching 50 6-inch shows. Everybody seems to be loving the Mandalorian. Yes, there's a few grumblies, but everyone's pretty happy with it. Somebody's not too happy about it. Christopher Miller's not too happy about potentially what's going to happen with JJ's film. You and I were just talking about that. I'm deeply skeptical. Matt's quite positive about it. So there you go. Everybody's got a different opinion. Kenneth Crayley Jr., thank you as always, sir. I think you've commented on every single show and video that I've done. You're a superstar. Michael Bell, he's enjoying the show. He's in the UK. Star Action Figures is definitely a good place. Matt and I have both used that. Definitely recommend it. They've been very good at getting a lot of exclusive stuff we've struggled to get. Both of us have had good experiences with them. Figuarts Emperor, yes, we did talk about that last week in the promo pics. Everybody's saying that does look quite good. The guards being traffic cones, okay. Leonard says, Norez says, I'm glad you're back. We're glad you're back too, Leonard. Thank you for that. Darth Emmett, great show, gentlemen. He wants a room tour from us both. Not a chance from me. Everything looks okay from my point of view. Matt's got his Christmas tree tonight, but everything's boxes everywhere anyway. So one day, Darth Emmett. Leonard says, Norris says again, we need stands. Oh my God, yes, we so need stands. Knight of Ren has quite a nice little top five he's got here. Obi-Wan Kenobi. I guess he's meaning Clone Trooper Obi-Wan Kenobi. Mace Windu.
No, it's episode one.
Episode one. Ah, okay. Interesting choice. Walmart exclusive Jedi Knight Luke, Cara Dune, and his number one is the Mandalorian. Good picks. And he's Walmart worthy Captain America as his favorite Marvel Legends. That's not a bad list, man. That's pretty good. Most of Europe is still waiting for the Mandalorian. Yes, that absolutely sucks, but I fully condone piracy because they're idiots. And what do they expect you to do? Be spoiled by the internet? Just go pirate the damn thing. You know what to do. Regarding Matt preferring all the Mandalorian episodes to premiere at once, he shakes the clone and says no, he likes them the weekly. I kind of want them all at once too, though. I kind of, like you, I'm kind of like, yeah, just, I don't know. Although it does give us something to look forward to every week, like really look forward
to. I enjoy the idea of the week to week. It's just at the end of the episode, I don't want to call it the weaker episodes, but the episodes that are a bit more lighter in subject, I like having the next episode to follow, and it plays out better for me. I've just done a second sitting where I've watched all five pretty much in a row, and it worked nicely, even though I'd seen them. If episode 2 and 3 flowed better together, episode 4 and 5 worked better together, and I think that 5 even works better with 6 on the other end of it. So, Anyway, it's I think I do like the 1 week at a time and spreading it out. It's just as a piece of storytelling, I'd prefer it to all follow each other.
Well, we get to, I mean, the good thing is you could just hold off and then watch the whole things all at once. So either way, it's it works for everybody. What's up, Chief? Good buddy of ours, Michael Crowell, he's struggling to get IG-11, and I've posted a couple links to you, mate, if you've not seen them yet. Robot Kingdom and Amazon.com.au for around $40 Australian. Don't worry, that thing's going to go down in price because it's not selling. This is the second or third person that said this to me. Why does Cal from the Jedi Fallen Order? A lot of people are not happy with the facial expression, the facial. Facial scan on him.
Likeness.
You played the game, right? No?
Twice,
okay. Hardcore.
Once as a Jedi Knight and once as Jedi Master.
Okay, you're hardcore son of a bitch, man. I like it. Facial scan, likeness?
Look, he looks enough like him, but again, I guess it could look more like the actor who plays him, who the scan's based on, but to me, it's close enough. I don't mind. I think it's a good looking figure.
Yeah.
And I think I think it's a good looking figure and it's close enough. It's closer than some of the actors on other figures. So
that's true.
You know.
Very, very true. Well, some of the news for Star Wars in the last few weeks while we were off air has been around some 6-inch figures which were revealed at Dortmund Comic Con in Germany. Lovely place. And the two figures that make up the remaining case have now been kind of full. Now we know exactly what they are, which is Commander Bly and a Jet Trooper. So looking very, very good indeed. Now they're already up at Darkseid, and I ordered, but I think they've still got cases left. Let's have a look. They might have sold out, actually. Oh, still got Bly as a single, which is pretty good. Because I know a lot of people just want him, so that's not a bad idea. I think they've sold out of cases. Holy balls. Okay, no cases left. So you can at least go and cherry pick your singles. There's plenty of singles left, but yeah, cases and waves have sold out, which is, wow, that went fast. Good wave, though. Pretty solid one. Was that one for you? Were you getting a case?
Yeah, look, I got one. Technically, I got a case, but I can't even remember. It's this stupid way that Hasbro did the reveal. So
I know.
One of them, I got a case, and the other one, I just ordered them all together as one individual wave or something. I started chopping and changing my order to make sure that I got it all together, but it just would have been easier to order the case of both rather than this. 2 released today, 2 released next week, 2 the week after, and just made ordering really difficult.
I know. I wish they'd just reveal them and then not let us order them.
Yeah.
You know, just hold the damn order until the case is fulfilled. That just made me, because all these retailers and e-tailers now had lots of people like you and I did exactly the same as you. I bought the Night of Rain, I bought the Zori Bliss, I bought the Count Dooku, and then they've lumped in the extra look into the case, which is fine. God, that's going to be, he's going to be so swinging in the pegs. And then these two came along. So yeah, there was a lot of faffing around for e-tailers and retailers and us. So yeah, I hope Hasbro would do that again. But it was good that the reveals, I must say that's the one thing I do love, is they're really giving lots of countries, Italy, Germany, France and Spain and the UK, everybody's getting a chance for the once in things the way they go. Because it was always San Diego Comic-Con, New York Comic-Con, that was it. So it's really nice to see. So I don't want to be too critical of that. But some good figures. I really like that wave. It's a really solid wave. Apart from Luke, which we've already had really twice now, if you think about it. But there we go. It's a very good-looking wave. Now, a tiny, insignificant character that nobody is talking about on the internet was also revealed, and that was Baby Yoda. And God, this thing just has been going nuts since the show. But this is the Black Series figure, a 1.2-inch, 3-centimeter little figure. Comes with the soup bowl, the ball from the ship, and the frog. And this is what makes me think that, you know, when you zoom in the high-res photograph, which is not here, but they did. I really don't think they knew about this. They didn't know about this. Otherwise, they would have came out. Literally, like the heavy Mandalorian, on that day, they would have had a prep, they would have been told about it. I think everybody, it was kept under wraps, very evidently from my perspective. And Mattel just got out the gate a few days before everybody else with a plush. Then even Hasbro jumped on the plush because they knew it was going to be a thing like that. But you look at all the pictures, they're all really speedily rendered. There's no real actual figure in situ. So, and it's not shipping until May, but given it's so small, June.
Look, they're reporting May now. I've been seeing, because it was June. They're saying summer, and then somebody said May. I don't know. Last thing I saw was, it could be June, but like May 25th. I'm guessing it's the Star Wars birthday scenario or whatever.
That's 1.2 inches. That's my thumb. That's Baby Yoda.
It's got seven points of articulation.
It does, but it's incredibly small, which is fine, but it's like...
what's the seven? You've got a head, the arms. You got the head.
Yeah.
The arms. Hands, maybe, would be...
Yeah, it will do. There'll be waist or something, some kind of waist.
And then waist, maybe, and legs should be straight and
yeah,
a block.
But. Kind of like a Jawa or something.
Yeah.
But it's basically a little porg, essentially. Not much bigger than a porg. But it'll sell buckets. It will sell buckets. So he's up for pre-order, and there's lots of different versions of him. Just if you want to, you know, everybody wants to do the Baby Yoda thing. You've got not 6 inches, but you've got obviously the 6-inch one we mentioned. They've got these little figures called the Bounty Collection, which actually were kind of cool. I think you and I both ordered some of them because they could almost go with the Black Series figures. Then you've got the Hasbro plush, and then there's another plush I think that was there that was a talking plush.
The talking plush, yeah. One's life size and one's an inch smaller.
10-inch pop and regular pop. I mean, maybe Yoda. But I think this was the thing. I mean, Funko didn't have it as soon as as soon as episode one, The Mandalorian, aired, Funko could have put their product, Hasbro, Mattel, others. But I think they were quick, draw something. And I think that's what it was. So.
But I also think that from what I was reading somewhere else, that Funko can go from concept to shelf in 12 weeks.
Correct. Correct.
But they're also May, so I think that Lucasfilm is holding them all back for May the 4th or May 25th, whatever it is.
Makes sense.
Because it can't be that they're all timing to that when Funko's turnaround time is much quicker than the others.
Yep.
And it would have the opportunity to get it out in February. So I think that obviously Lucasfilm is controlling still the when on Baby Yoda, and I don't know. It's strange and it's funny, and I guess we'll just wait and see. They've got a plan.
Mm. Yakfeast.com reported a rumor of a Black Series 6-inch scaled probe droid, and his information coincides with our information that we've got, and so that pretty much looks like the rumor is going to be an absolute certainty. So that's two different sources saying that that rumor is very likely to happen. So that's a very interesting piece of info. Sure won't be the last, as Toy Fair really is 8 weeks, 10 weeks around the corner, which is kind of exciting. Less than that, in fact. That is pretty much it for Star Wars. I can't think of anything else Star Wars we missed. You're going to the premiere tomorrow, you lucky man. Yep. You're going to an exclusive swanky premiere first, before us libs. Yes, you are. And I'm going at midnight tomorrow, so yeah, it will be interesting. However, top 10 figures of 2019. I'll let you see your bit, and we'll go with you first, if that's okay. If you want to paste in your list, are you going to, can you share, or do you want me to, you want to send
me? No, I can share all but one. So I've got,
okay, we'll get to
you've
that.
You've got the one. You don't know where that one falls, but
I do know where that one falls. Okay. You can tell me and I'll find it. You can tell me and I'll find it. I'll find it. Yeah. Before we do, just my caveat would be, this is our top 10. It's not your top 10. Please don't send death threats, because some people get really weird about, you know, that bigger crap. And so leave your comments in the comments below. I should have said all the show notes, all the links of the products in the top 10s we talk about will be underneath the video in the description. From my perspective, it's a kind of combination of just what I like, appreciation for the sculpt and the figure and the paint and the deco and the coolness factor. And there's no major science to this. So, yeah, just enjoy and roll with it. And I'd agree and disagree with this as you go on. But
and I'll add to mine, it can also be influenced just by my personal attachment to it.
Mm,
and even in saying that, before I even say my 10, I'll give one honorable mention that didn't make the 10.
Okay.
But it's one of my most beloved figures and characters and versions of the character and everything else.
Yep.
But it just didn't nail it in the way I needed it to nail it. And that is Trash Compactor Luke Stormtrooper.
Oh,
he would be in my 10 any other time, but that lip and nose thing knocked it out compared to the other 10 that I chose. So again, on sentimental kind of scoring, yeah, that could go to number one. But when I got to it, I just couldn't. I couldn't get him into the 10. So he's an honourable mention. So don't wait for him at number one, because he's not there. So with that, my number 10 is number 101, Cara Dune.
Cara Dune. All right, man. All right. Let's have a closer look at Cara Dune. For those who don't know what we're talking about, we'll just we'll share on screen and you can see a little more. You actually get the physical items there.
Yes, I do. I've got the physicals.
Oh my God, you're
here.
Good. You've done your homework. So Cara Dune, yes, just to let's have a little appreciation very quickly of Hasbro's photography that they've done, because they did a good job. Something I missed. She has a little knife slot in her boot, which is great. And yeah, good figure. So what was your thoughts about her?
God, look, I just think it's a good representation of her. It's a good figure from my page's point of view. The way she photographs with the Mandalorian and IG-11 and the heavy duty Mando, they're a great set of figures from the TV show, with the exception of IG-88, but he still photographs well enough within a group shot. But I just think that it's a solid figure. It's all original. It's new. It's not reusing any figure, or yep, even looking like any figure. The guns are good. The weapons are good. It's the skin tones are good too, again, without that shiny look being on it that the humans have been having of late. So
I agree.
All over, I just think it's a good looking figure and it photographs really well. And, you know, I think we'll have more to see of her in the series. So
good start to the 10, sir. I like it.
That's 10. Number 9 does come with a sentimental factor, and I've been waiting a long time for it and wanting it. And You can make it either Skywalker Strikes or Yavin Luke, whichever way you want. It would probably be the Skywalker Strikes version because it comes with all those extra bits, but it doesn't lend well to what I'm doing right now. So let's call it Yellow Jacket Luke is number 9.
Let's just for a second, just we'll have a little look at Luke. There's the Skywalker Strikes one. And yeah, I just reviewed it the other day as well. And it is a very nice figure, a lot of nice parts to it, just that exclusive. So what did you like about it? What key things were the
Look, namely, it was a figure that I thought I've wanted it for years. So it was delivering on that kind of, not nostalgic, but that want of something that should have been done because it was easy. And I get to that point of view where Farm Boy Luke's is such a disappointing figure for me. Mm. And then Bespin Luke was disappointing. This one falls in between the two. And look, I just wanted a good Luke again. I want another shot of a good Luke face again with Trash Compactor Luke not being a great face. Mm. And again, the in-hand figure looks better than these photos do. The sculpt That's and true. The hair and everything. But it's just that kind of suit from the Marvel comics and everything. It's just a figure I wanted. And we got it and we were waiting for it and expecting it. But it delivers and it's a solid Mark Hamill face compared to a lot of the earlier figures, and we weren't getting, I don't know. It's, yeah, anyway, it's there.
I love the whole deluxe aspect of it, the fact that you just get all these extras. It's a really, I'm happy to pay more for money when you get such nice little extras like that. It's nice. What else you got?
So what was that? That was number 9. Number 8 is
Foxy. Nice.
So look, there's not much to say. He's red. He's a clone trooper, and he looks really cool. It's really good paint deco. The kind of weathering is probably one of the... A lot of the clone troopers have good weathering, but this is probably the best weathering to date. It doesn't look... it looks real. It looks scuffy. It's got great scratches there on the nose and the front. And again, in hand, that's looking... not as good as it does in hand, but in hand it's a really solid kind of it looks like it's been given its wash that all the customizers give the white.
I agree. That stuff. Wash is good.
He's an easy one and he could probably rank up higher and everything else, but I'm not a clone fan. I'm not the biggest clone fan, but I love a good looking figure and that's a good looking figure.
I agree. Who's next?
Next is
drum roll.
Jedi Knight.
Oh my god, he's really high up your list. I thought he was going to be like number 1.
So look, you know me. I love the figure. I love the face. The longer I've stayed with him, I've changed my position on him. I think on Force Friday, I was a little bit disappointed with it in a. Talked about it before, it was a build-up more of maybe, let's say, I wanted my deluxe Jedi Knight figure. I wanted my Skywalker Strikes version of it. I wanted cloaks. I wanted removable tunics. I wanted removable hands, glove, no glove, damaged hand. I wanted Endor. I wanted the lot as a deluxe figure. I wanted the Hot Toys version of the 6-inch figure. I think they got it all right. I think they nailed it. The face is great. The longer you sit with it, I like the soft goods cape as well. I think once you can get it to sit properly, it sits really well. The hair is accurate to the terrible 1983 haircut of Mark Hamill. I just think, and I think I said it last week, I think that rather than trying to be incredibly screen accurate on bad hair, they should find the hair that fits Luke and fits the face. And I think it's the hair that slightly is jarring. It can be photographed from an angle really well, but on the wrong angle, the hair looks bad. And it's like, I get the need to be accurate, but look, there's a custom on my page. And maybe I know we're not doing my page today, but if you look up my page, I think somewhere in the last 10 shots, I've shared somebody who had a casting cave custom for this head, and it's kind of like the hair is not 1983 Luke Skywalker, but it's an incredible head sculpt, and it's what we could have got if you don't play with the...
Is it this one?
That's the one.
Hmm. I don't really have a big... Again, this is something you and I kind of differ on. I don't really have an issue with the Jedi Knight look too much. The face is very non-expressive. But again, I think it's very accurate to the movie. I think it's quite... It does have that incredibly hairsprayed hair kind of weird look about it, but yeah, it's... I don't know.
I think I'm also, as we've probably established, overly critical on the figures that I want the most out of.
Sure.
Like, cool. If this was nailed for me, that's the number one figure.
Mm.
It's the number one figure without a doubt. Like, it's my Jedi Knight Luke. I wanted a new version of it because the other one was... for me, so bad, at least in hindsight. It was demanding a photo reel treatment, which it got. It's just, you know, it's still probably an 8 or even a 9 out of 10, but for me, this should have been an 11 out of 10. And because it's not, it's got some points difference between where I needed it to be and where it is.
I still think there's an avenue for Hasbro to do more with that figure in 2 or 3 years' time, with a kind of skiff battle Jedi Knight look. You know, the blaster again, no cape, hair maybe got that more, that kind of very strong kind of card back where he's on top of the skiff with the lightsaber, the hands damaged, we could have some details on there, a bit of scuff here and there. There's potential to do that again with a different
look. And there's also a potential to do a Skywalker Strikes Deluxe, Matt's Deluxe figure in 2023 as well for the 40th anniversary and take another bash at. And what I'd really like to see in the Deluxe figures is a little bit more Marvel Legends thing too. It's not just hands and Endor equipment and tunic, no tunic and glove and hand, and stuff. It's also give us 2 or 3 heads. Like, they don't Star Wars just don't do it. They don't do it. Marvel does it. You know, particularly in re-releases, like Punishers get 2 heads. Wolverines get 2 heads. You know, even in the Builder figures, you've got Skrulls with 2 heads. And
yeah, true.
Kingpin gets 2 heads, technically, through different things. Like, just on a deluxe version, just give, you know, Skiff.
Give us
take on SH figure arts. Give us Skiff Luke. Give us Endor Luke with a helmet, and just give us whatever it is. Just a different expression now to this one, and you know, treat toy photographers to also being able to set up different shots with different expressions, kind of thing. Yeah, sometimes they do great shots.
No, I
still have the
yeah
the toy face.
I was arguing with someone on Twitter this week. He was kind of. A little bit annoyed that Hasbro had made a Commander Zuvio, Captain Zuvio, whatever the hell he's called, from the Constable. Force Awakens. Constable, thank you. I knew it was in there somewhere, down with the sea. But anyway, Constable Zuvio, he was really annoyed at Hasbro for making that figure. And I was like, they didn't know he was going to be cut from the movie.
Yeah.
I think if we really knew again, you know, I've talked about this, the horrible processes of, you might have a great idea, Lucasfilm has to approve it, Disney has to approve it, then the artist says, no, I don't like my face, and you have to scrap it. There's a whole bunch of stuff we never see, and all we do is whinge at Hasbro. He was saying, oh, you're a Hasbro apologist. I'm like, have you watched any of my videos? No, I am definitely not a Hasbro apologist, but I think we all have to appreciate, and that's part of doing this show, is, and I always kind of come back to Boba, a $20 figure like that, I challenge anyone to make a figure from scratch from and charge $21 for it and see how cheated you would feel. Obviously, you do it at scale, but they do some great stuff. They definitely have misses, but yeah, anyway, on a rant there about that. But I think it's a good figure. I think you're appreciating it, and it's definitely in your top 10, so not a bad fig. What's next?
Next figure. Mace Windu.
Mace Windu, this party is over. Funnily enough, he may appear in mine. He's pretty damn good.
It's just...
It's badass,
it nails
it?
That face. And You know, I don't have the SH Figure Arts version. I can only compare on photos. And I would have said the SH Figure Arts was the best at the time, the best 6-inch figure of Star Wars, that the way people captured it. And then this one turned up and I'm kind of like, in photos and basing it on photos and also people's toy photography now, I'm like, the Hasbro one at $20 and even maybe articulation SH Figure Arts wins. But when you come to Head Sculpt now, Samuel L. Jackson is the Black Series one. When you put them side by side for me, again, SH Figure Arts might have that articulation that works really well with the different joints and stuff. But when it comes to the face and actual likeness to Phantom Menace, Samuel L. Jackson, to me, the Black Series one wins. And I think, again, this could be number one or it could be number, I think it's number five or something, I don't know. One, two, three, it's number five. It could be number one. But it's just where I'm sitting today. But it's such a beautiful looking figure.
You're beautiful, Sam. We love you. It really is this is probably less than an inch, this head we're looking at here. And it's pretty damn phenomenal. And this is the point where, you know, people say, oh, you're a Hasbro apologist. No, I'm a Hasbro freaking appreciative person. Because look at it. It really is superb. It is. For $20, you're getting this gorgeous head sculpt. Now, you and I have talked many times about loads of customizers online. And we've bought replacement heads. And those guys, for them to do it and even just cover the costs, you're talking about a $35, $40 shipped cost. So it's a damn good figure and a good pick. So what's number four?
Number four, I changed this just before the show started.
What'd you go for?
Mandalorian.
Why did you change?
Because I love him, but...
But, yeah, I agree.
And this one I do have out of packet and I've played with and I've set up with, and he looks awesome. He is awesome. He photographs great. And it's more about what we didn't get from him.
Yeah.
And it's the cape.
Correct.
And I love that it sits. I love that it's perfect, but it's also the wrong plastic. If they could have done this cape out of even whatever they use for Kylo Ren's cape or Last Jedi, or more importantly, what they use for the Hulk's ripped shirt. That is the best, soft goods plastic for the 80th anniversary or the Grey Hulk. That white and that orange ripped shirt is the best plastic for capes and fabric, etc. And I just would have wanted soft goods, or I also wanted some kind of enamel or shinier helmet than what we got.
Yeah.
Looks good in the photo, but in figure, it's a duller chrome or duller gray. Mm. And you know, flip side is they had the carbonized version, which had a better, shinier helmet, but the body was just the gimmick of the shine, as opposed to this that probably looks better. And the last thing I'd say, being critical of it on why it dropped down my list, is seeing this outfit as the first outfit and not the later outfit or whatever, a little bit of weathering, like they've given Fox weathering and all that stuff. They've got their scraps and stuff there, but that under the beige undershirt at the moment, that should have had some either dirty or weathering, or it's just a little bit too clean. Look, I love the figure. But when I had to bring it down just before the show, I was looking at going, does it really stand above my other ones? And the answer is, I don't know. So I had to bring it down. And look, we're going to get another shot at the Mando in 2020.
Oh, totally.
There is no way we're not getting the Beskar outfit. And there's no way they're not announcing that.
The jetpack version. And we'll get more.
So he's down there knowing that he might be back up higher next year. So we'll wait and see. So the next one, which I think is number four, is
only number four. Sacrilege.
So he is he is everything that the Mando's not. He delivers. He's only in it for, we all know how much he's in it, but he's well, he's sculpted well. He looks good. He's painted well. The jetpack, the armor, it's just a kick-ass heavy figure. And I don't know much more to say about him other than it's a really great figure. But let's just say my top three have sentimental attachments and love to it. And that's why Mando and heavy duty Mando has dropped to four and five, because the next three are, you know, something that I really wanted to see and have wanted for a long time. And I've got that attachment to them over these guys at this point in time.
Okay. Oh, good. Good pick. He's up there. He's number, what was that, four?
Number four. So number three, I don't own.
Oh.
I don't own my number three top figure. Yes. So it would be Hondo.
Hondo Naka.
From the Galaxy's Edge collection. I've always loved him in Clone Wars and Rebels, and then they've announced him and they've put him in that damn three pack. But from these images and the images I've shared on my page, it's such an incredible looking figure.
And if
we're not going to get this version in 2020, give us the Clone Wars version of him. Give us same figure, same whatever. Give us the green jacket or whatever it is. Just give us a different version of exactly this sculpt. I don't care.
Yep.
But he's a great figure. He's the figure I want, and he's the figure that pushes me to go, oh, am I going to spend $200 to get one figure? And right now the answer is no. But I can't escape the fact that that's my number three figure. And there's probably a little bit of desire playing into that score.
Okay. So. Okay. You may be able to get him a lot cheaper than you think, but okay. That's a good choice for number three. Number two. Drum roll, please. Oh, okay, the Boba. Oh, my God. All right. So I can see the sentimental aspect of that. So
it's purely sentimental. It's something that you and I have been talking about for three years now, the 2.5 years, whatever it is. We've been talking about it. It was going to come. It came, and I dig it. I haven't opened him yet, so I dig him as a visual piece of collecting plastic art kind of thing. And it's just, that's it. There's not much more to say. It's Boba Fett. The articulation's not great. It's not perfect. They've made some changes, but they've kept it into the Black Series feel. I love the color scheme. I love the card back. I love the release. It's there, and it's my second favorite figure of the year, regardless of its faults. Again, it doesn't matter.
Yep. Wow, we have very different top tens. Kind of. It's quite interesting. It really is quite interesting to do this. And I hope if you're watching, please leave yours. It's really interesting to compare other people's top tens of figures they liked. Released in 2019. Okay, so we've had nine really pretty awesome figures. What's number one?
Now, number one's a strange, well, it's not a strange one, but it is strange because it's not the greatest figure.
Okay.
But it is, I think, the greatest head sculpt.
Okay.
And
best figure 2019.
Even on my page, when this was announced,
yep,
and I shared the photos of it, by far and away, it was the biggest reactions of anything in likes. It went up to like, when we're getting 1,000, 2,000 likes an image, which nobody can see anymore. I'd post a picture of this at whatever the con was. I think it was New York or something, on the table, and then I'd put it on display, and it'd be 8,000 likes and 7,000 likes, and that is Clone Commander.
Okay, good call. Good call.
So nice. Look, again, there's lots of faults with the figure, and it could be better, and it is just a kit bash. In the sense of the clone body, which is and isn't perfect. It's a Jedi Knight with a trigger figure and all that stuff that you can complain about. But that head, it's just...
This show is all about the head. Absolutely, I absolutely agree with you.
Inches in head. It's just.
Oh boy, but you're right. It's definitely about the. I mean, they've nailed it in the last since Solo. They have just nailed facial scans, and it's just made it's refreshed the whole line, saved the whole line. I think because it was wobbling at one point. I felt with the sparkly My Little Obi, the Dagobah version. So, what do you love about this? Is it just?
Look, it's also just captures, like, I mean, again, I know that this version of General Kenobi or Clone Commander Kenobi or whatever it is Revenge of the Sith head on the original Clone Wars animation body, and it should be the Jesus head more, the clone Attack of the Clones head that we're getting next year. That should be on this armor. But it is Ewan McGregor. It just is. It's my favorite version of Obi-Wan from the prequels is Revenge of the Sith. That head is essentially Ewan McGregor, Revenge of the Sith. Mustafa, you were the chosen one, Anakin, kind of thing.
Yes, I agree. I agree.
It just works. And it also came out of nowhere. Like, no one knew this one was coming. This one didn't leak. It just showed up that day at the con, and it was just like, WTF kind of thing. Where did that come from?
I know.
And it just blew up, and it's kind of like, you know, I've got the, I did get the Old Boy Customs repaint of that head as well. So I've got that version, which doesn't need a repaint, but just when you get that Old Boy touch to it, it gives it that Hot Toys feel. So that sculpt is there sitting on the original, my original Wave 1, Phase 1, Obi-Wan, that terrible Revenge of the Sith body, and it just looks incredible. It's like, it's, I don't know, it's just, that's my number one figure because it was unexpected. Obi-Wan's my favorite character in the whole saga, kind of thing. As we know with old Ben Kenobi, desperate for that figure to come out when it came out. Ewan's Obi I love from the prequels. It's what I do love about the prequels. So it was just unexpected, and it just nailed it. And it's like, again, I know it doesn't work for articulation. I know it's got a trigger finger. I know that it's not accurate to the Clone Wars cartoon. I know it's not accurate to the Clone Wars original series. I know it doesn't work for all those reasons, but I was just like, I love it. So that's number one.
It's a good choice. Good pick. I like your choice. And it may or may not be in my top 10, but it's a really good figure and a really good top 10. And I think every one of them is a high quality figure. They're all really good. And I think what's coming through is obviously those facial scans again. Just the rest of the figures haven't changed dramatically really from a few years ago, but the addition of that sculpt in the face is just knocking out the park, I think, in terms of making a figure. Good. That was a good job,
I should say my honourable mentions.
Mm-hmm. Go for it.
So those that didn't make my 10, and we've already said Stormtrooper Wet Hair Luke.
Yep.
Different reasons. Padawan Obi-Wan Kenobi, Episode 1, Ewan McGregor. He didn't make it, and he could have made it in there. The re-release of The Emperor could have made it and didn't, but it's a little bit, again, the old figure, but soft goods. The heads, the throne, everything. It's a great release, but didn't make it. The second sister could have made it.
And wow, didn't. I didn't like her at all, actually. Wow.
Yeah, I do, but I like the game and you know,
sure,
it plays in. Who else do I have in there? Now, as a cheat, Archive Yoda could have made it, but I've left the archive out. I've left him out. And I really like Rise of Skywalker, the Rise of Skywalker Rey. I really like it, but I've left her out of the 10. Yeah.
Okay. I don't like that.
And the last one, which I can guarantee is in yours somewhere, I'm betting, and didn't make mine, and he's the best of the best of the rest, is Mud Trooper Han Solo.
Maybe.
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 So that's my
okay. That's good top 10 though. Good 10 and good honorable mentions. I had lots of honorable mentions. I thought, screw it. No, it's got to be 10, and they've got to go in there. And like you, it's kind of, it's just what my favorite figures were for sculpt design, packaging, what you got in the package, impact. And here's my top 10. Numero 10 for me, and initially I had this figure, Hasbro kindly sent it from San Diego Comic Con. I had a look at it, and I really wasn't too enamored. But when this baby came along in the carbonized version, I have to say it blew me away. I think the paint on this one just popped the crap out of it, and really made it what it could have been. It's the, to me, by far the best carbonized figure that Hasbro have done. Love that pose as well. It just looks Saturday Night Fever there. It looks really cool. The regular version is so dull and flat now, but this one with that shine on it, and especially in these photographs here, it just... movie prop Hot Toys quality. It just shows you what the paint can really do. Carbonized Mandalorian did not cut it for me at all. It just, the glittery cape and the what? It just kind of went off the rails, but I think this figure, just all the blacks there shining off that armor just absolutely nailed it. So carbonized Sith Trooper for me was right in there. Just love all the tones and colors and reflections, and it is a beautiful looking figure, especially with the paint. So that is number 10. Number 9 for me was one that you had, and I agree for all the points that we talked about, was Cara Dune. She just had a beautiful figure, all the poses, all the stuff. I absolutely adored the little rebel tattoo on her cheek, and it just really worked. But again, as you can highlight, the sculpt, the weathering was just right and minimal. She had nice little touches on it. The weapon was good. The knife, which I finally found out did work and stored the weapon, it just nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. They did such a good job on that figure. So that was number 9. Number 8 for me was one you just covered as well. So very similar top 10. That was Sexy Foxy. Just too good. He really was pretty stunning. All the things you mentioned, the chromed weapons, just the right amount of weathering. Just a shame that one was an exclusive. It was a little bit harder for a lot of people to get hold of. Not super hard, but you know, just more complication. That's a shame because it's such a popular figure. Whether you're into clones or not, as you said, you're not a huge clone fan, but it's still very popular. Number, dun, 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 let me check my list to make sure. Yep, number 7 is kind of similar to yours as well, one of the Galaxy's Edge packs, and that is the First Order Mountain Trooper in this pack. Now, I only just got this a few weeks ago, but it's superb. It is as if a First Order Trooper had a baby with... A Scarif Trooper, exactly, and they had a Mountain Trooper. It's really hard to see. I don't have a great quality photograph, but you've got a lot of brand new sculpts. It uses the thighs from the Scarif Trooper. The Mouse Droid's not really a figure. Commander Pyre's quite nice, but he's really just a repaint with some good elbows, and you were right. He does have good elbows. They did fix that. Kylo, meh. Same rubbish Kylo we had before. But the Mountain Trooper, I highly recommend people pick up. I managed to get the pack for around 100 US shipped, which is really not bad considering it's 70 bucks plus sales tax. So really about 77 US at Disneyland. So a little bit more expensive, but you know, chance to get the pack was pretty good. So Hondo is a little bit cheaper actually, because the two figures in that people just do not want. So you can pick up the pack for a little bit less and get it shipped. So it would be under that 200 you talked about. But Mountain Trooper is number 7, and really, I've just put up a review of it tomorrow, but really impressed. He's my new Scarif. He's really cool. I still love the Scarif. What was number 6? Well, number 6 was actually just, again, another one of yours, so it sounds like a little repeating. Mace Windu. He was, just as you said, he's just an absolutely kick-ass figure. Sam Jackson, just absolutely nailing it. And again, that facial sculpt. This party is over. It is such a good head sculpt. Every little detail on him is banging. The cape is good. The lightsaber's good. It's superb. I actually picked just another one up in the Black Friday sales. It was just so cheap. I thought, God damn, yes, I need another one. I chose at number five in the list. And whilst there's a lot of things I don't like about it, and you just raised some, it was Palpatine on Throne. I think I was that excited that I found it that day in the listings. That I was just so excited for this figure, like nobody really knew about it. And I think you were the first person I told, and I was like, oh my God, there's a Palpatine. And so there was a genuine excitement and passion for it. But I think what I love about it is these deluxe sets. I love these greedy, evil little face sitting in that chair. The chair's just superb, Gregory Titus's artwork. And I love the cheeky little heads as they pop out through these little designs. It just, they did a good job with the design. It really isn't a great figure because it is the reused figure. And there's the hands they've changed, the sockets and the hands they've changed from the previous one, which was kind of really annoying. But, you know, we finally got a Palpatine on a throne. I mean, geez, it took them even long enough, I think, in the 3.75 inch line to do one. So, I just liked it. I really do like it. And he sits and he looks like an evil little shit on the shelf. And I just love him. People have Elf on the shelf. I have Palpatine on the shelf. So there you go. That was number five. Number four was the Mandalorian, just like you. Good figure, but did not make it into number one. It just, as you said, weathering. What is this? Clean, super clean, just washed undersuit. Just a little unfinished. The rifle would not stick in the back of that awful cape. And I know we're going to get another one with a proper soft goods cape and maybe some carbonized details or some other kind of effects on the figure, the Beskar, etc. So it's a good figure, and he's selling like hotcakes, but it's just not quite, just a couple of things let it down, which was a shame. It didn't quite go into the top figures of the year. So we're into the top three. And the next one is just as you said, and again for all the reasons, clone Obi-Wan Trooper from Walgreens. He just, it's, you were the chosen one face. It just nails it. And I think on top of the clone body with the cape, it's banging. I'm not bothered about the trigger figure, to be honest. It really doesn't bother me one bit. But yeah, I'd love to see. We did at one point in Genndy Tartakovsky's series have both Anakin and Mace with partial armor. Yeah. Clone armor. So that, you know, I'm up for it. Do it more. That'd be really, really good. I'd be completely up for that with a Mace head. I must try the Mace head on the Obi-Wan figure, actually see what it's like. So that was number three. Really strong, solid figure. And like you, came out the blue, just loved it. Number two was Heavy Mando. Just what a figure. My God. And I really struggled with this one because he was my number one to begin with. He was just like, oh, he's got to be number one. He's got to be number one. And he really is just stunning. The weathering was beautifully done and balanced. The way you could store the weapon. Everything about the design of it had been really executed very well. A little bit of problems a lot of people had with the front arm and the cable and so forth, but it really is chunky, funky, and just goddamn awesome. The photographs as well, for once, really sold it. You and I have talked about this before, that sometimes the toy photographers, sorry dudes, that photograph the figures, particularly 3.75 inch figures, they get the wrong blaster around the wrong way, or they kind of, it just looks really wacky. But they freaking nailed the photography for this one, and it just looks really just awesome. Just loved everything about it, even though in the back of the figure the detail was there. So the Heavy Mando was nearly number one for me, but I really swithered and had a good think about it. And the one that came through, and damn you for noticing, sir, because I didn't think you would have, it was the Mimban Trooper. Han Solo Mimban Trooper, and it came out just as we turned into 2019. And you know me well, clearly. It just did everything, this figure. I think the key thing was, you could unmask him. You could have a proper, you know, Mimban Trooper there, or Mud Trooper. Looked really good. The weathering was absolutely superb, and the scoring all the way down. The keep was good. It came on and off. It was a little bit problematic, but the way they executed that helmet and the design of it, and you could still take it off and have a head sculpt underneath, which wasn't admittedly great, but it was still pretty good. Still got weathering in the hair. There was a lot of love went into this figure, and I think it really, really shows. It's one that has kept its value, and it's still pretty expensive, but you kind of get that look for the figure. You get the unmasked look for the figure, and you get the helmeted figure, which I really love that you can army build this guy really easily. Kind of got scattered.
I would say, as much as the head sculpt might be a little bit off, when the helmet's on, the head sculpt is 100% on. It's just the accommodating hair for the helmet kind of thing.
Absolutely.
That shot of and any angle you can get of the face with that helmet on in that scenario, the face is spot on. It's just when you take it off and you kind of got basically what we're saying is we don't like helmet hair.
Yes, but it's the technicality of this figure I think I like is the fact that you can both get that looks it's perfectly acceptable in the Black Series line. There's nothing wrong with it per se. But they still managed to accommodate all this junk and stuff around them and all these really complicated elements in with the helmet, in with the different components and parts of it. And it just, I don't know, everything about the roof.
It's a $20 figure and it does not look like a $20 figure.
It's still $27. It's not the most expensive figure, but it's definitely one I think that, it's just going to go up and up in value. And I know a lot of customizers on, particularly there's a couple of good groups on Facebook, 112 Galaxy is good, and a few others. And this one was just bought by the bucket load, and you know, all different heads and styling and different kind of patches and so forth. So that was my number one. And damn you, you knew what I was going to pick.
No, I didn't. I just knew he'd be in your 10. No, but I knew he was going to be in your 10. I didn't know he was going to be number one.
Well, that was good timing, fortuitous timing. That was interesting. That was very interesting. Our top figures of 2019. Again, if you're watching, what were your figures? Let us know. Love to hear your thoughts and comments. Did you agree with Matt or I? Which ones did you like? Did you like our top threes? Let us know. I think that's just for Star Wars. Let's move on. Still got a top 10 for Marvel Legends. We've got some Marvel toy news as well. A couple of things very quickly on that front. We had Black Widow figures since we last did a show. And here's all of the wave if you are not aware. They're up for pre-order, but you got a couple of Taskmasters. What's she called? Hold on a second. I can't even see the damn image. There we go. Yelena Belova. There you go. I don't want to murder the name. Black Widow, Red Guardian. We get Crossbones again. We get Marvel Spymaster and Winter Soldier. And the Build-A-Figure is the Crimson Dynamo, which is from a comic. But any of these you think are pretty essential or you like?
I'm passing on all of them.
Really? Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Okay.
I could be tempted by, again, because I don't have him, Winter Soldier, maybe Crossbones comic thing, but I'm not even looking forward to the film. I'll happily go and see Black Widow. I think it's kind of like 2 years too late. And again, how they choose to do it following from Endgame, and it's totally got my head whatever from anyway. It's just something that it's kind of like, Marvel had the opportunity to do this film even 4 years ago, 5 years ago before Wonder Woman. And they've just kind of left it, oh, we better do it after Wonder Woman was a big success. And they couldn't do it whilst they had everything else in motion. It's just, I don't know, I'm just not hyped for it. And the figures don't really excite me.
Whole opposite. I think I'm such a Winter Soldier fan that kind of connection in some ways and still keeping that thread going to what happened in the past is... got red in the ledger, man. She's got to get rid of it. It's just, yeah, it looks really good to me. Taskmaster, I'm not so sure about him in the movie, but certainly a good-looking figure, and Red Guardian and others. So, yeah, I'm up for it. A couple of other figures got revealed. One is the Retro Storm. She looks badass. I'm not really that much of a big X-Men fan, but that is a very cool looking retro figure. One for you?
Look, I've ordered it. Okay. I've ordered it to keep my now X-Men collection with both versions of the team in order. But look, I really like it. I'm surprised. I kind of feel like Hasbro released the white version, got the reaction to the white version, and went, shit, we better get the black version out. Because otherwise, they should have done one as a wave one and one as an exclusive one closer together.
Yeah,
kind of thing, like, you know, I don't know, but it does feel like it's a reactionary figure rather than a well planned out figure. It's just kind of like, and here we go, we've just got this random one that's not an 80 years figure and it's not a part of any other wave and it's a different version, a variant to what was released 4 months ago, 3 months ago. It's like, it feels like, oh shit, we better get something out. And I'm happy they are, because it's the version that I kind of felt should have come out the first time. So, yeah, it's good.
We also had, I think a lot of people had to Google up these ladies, the Cuckoos, the Stepford Cuckoos, not the Stepford Wives, but the Stepford Cuckoos, these telepathic, telekinetic ladies that basically come with three kind of swap out heads, you can swap out. Kind of really reminds me of was it Yo-Yo Gabari, or what was her name from Kill Bill? But somebody pointed out the knees. Ugh, it just looks terrible with the knees. But if you two wanted a Asian schoolgirl Marvel Legends, then the day has come for you. So there you go, and swap out heads. So I think that's what most male buyers are probably buying it for. So, but kind of fun pack. And at least Marvel's doing some really kind of, for me, bizarre off-the-shelf characters. Have you heard of these guys?
No.
Stepford Cuckoos. What a name. Oh,
but,
my.
You know, again, it is 100% the perfect exclusive. And I think, is it a Walgreens exclusive?
It is Walgreens. Yeah. Exactly.
It's the perfect exclusive. You can find how to get it if you want it, and if you don't, it doesn't really impact your collection.
Exactly. I did include at one point some of the DC deceased figures, which are brand new, but they're 7 inches, so you don't qualify to be on our kill show. Sorry. No. DC or deceased figures, they're pretty cool, but again, they're a little bit bigger, so we'll skip them. What is in range for DC is these figures, just to give DC a little bit of love. And it's these animated figures, which are kind of cool. Justice League animated figures. So if you're up for these, BBTS has all of these up. And they're pretty good looking figures. There's a cool Joker and Batman in there. And they're just over 6 inches tall. So just a little bit bigger. But very stylized from the animated show.
So these were originally just available as whatever the DC network is in the States.
Oh, so
the DC streaming service. So you could only buy them if you'd subscribed to the service. And now, a year later, they've now come out with Big Bad Toy Store as another way of purchasing them.
Okay. There you go. Did not know. All right. That is DC. And I think we've covered most of the bits and pieces there. It's time for another top 10. 2019 Marvel Legends figures, 10 figures from each of us. We'll go with Matt again. Let's see our top 10s, whether they match or not. There were tons of figures to choose from, but let's hear what you got. Look,
so I will qualify this as, these are just figures I like, and pretty much with the exception of one, figures I own, and I do not own Marvel Legends in the same way that I do Star Wars the Black Series. So number 10 for me is, because I think it's a great representation of how he appeared in the film, and a variation of what we got from the comic book version, and it works as its own figure, and that is Mysterio.
Nice. Okay.
He's number 10. And yeah, I just think it's a It's a good movie MCU figure, and that's number 10.
Nice. Shame we didn't get the head with that. That would have been nice. The movie.
That would have been good, yeah.
That would have ranked that up a whole lot higher. But still, you're right. Definitely a good looking figure. Cool.
Number 9, biggish, chunky figure. Really cool, but I think they could have done a better head for him. That is Beast.
Nice.
So, great figure, good articulation. Everything about him is good. He's solid. It's just, again, in the Marvel Legends world, we could have got a second head with this, and I've seen some great customs that nothing changes on the body. You don't need to repaint it or anything. It's just there is a different version of this head that we could get that's more, I don't know, anyway, more accurate to the comic. Or not that this is not accurate. It's just I've seen things that I like better. But a great figure.
Yeah, it's been one that's been incredibly popular with a lot of people. And as you said, customizers, I've seen quite a few different heads, particularly ones with glasses on, which is an interesting touch. But yeah, it's definitely a very poseable figure. Big giant blue dudes in their underpants is not for me, but I see the love and the appreciation by many, many people. So I can respect that. But I did love the way the fun they had with the figure and the photographs and the posting and the articulated toes, man. You don't get that very often. Well worth an entry in the top 10.
Cool. So next in the list is Thor. Alex Ross Thor.
Nice.
And again, I honestly, when the photos were first released, I was a bit blah about him. And yeah. When they first revealed him, I was like, ah, yeah, Thor, it's boring, it's comic Thor and everything else. And then I started to see the photos of it, or we got these then product pictures and stuff. I'm like, that's actually looking pretty good. I think I probably want it. And then I saw what people were doing with the photos, and I was like, I really want it. And I think at that point, they were then sold out. And then they came back in stock, and I was like, I got to grab it. So I just grabbed them, and yeah, Thor was the next one. It's just a good comic version. Again, in that shot, he looks okay. In hand, he looks so much better.
I noticed that with these figures, yeah. They really are pretty well made, though. Yep. Good job.
And good and chunky and weighty as well. It's
yep.
It's solid. So that's number, what was that? 10, 9, 8. Number 7 is Alex Ross Iron Man.
Nice.
And again, I thought at first when the first images came out with the actual Alex Ross helmet and the gold wasn't looking right and it was looking a bit, again, naff. And as soon as it came out and I was seeing pictures, people's pictures in hand and their toy photography, I'm kind of like, that's Secret Wars Iron Man. That's my 80s Iron Man. That's the Iron Man I want. And in hand, it's a great looking figure. So
they poured magic on these kind of vintage style figures. There's just something about them that just don't know. They just nailed them. They really did nail them. Yep.
So yeah, he's where are we up to? Seven? I've forgotten again. What number was he? He was 7, was he? Yeah, he was 7. So number 6 is War Machine.
Nice. I did not peg you for a War Machine, dude. All right.
I'm kind of not, but I am for this. I am for this one. So look, I just really liked it. And you know, I will ruin one thing and say that Iron Patriot is not in my list because I don't have him. And as you say, I'm not a War Machine kind of guy. So I'm sure I'm gonna love it when I get it in hand. But I do have this one in hand and it's solid and it's awesome.
It is. It's quite an incredible sculpt that they've done, which they probably, you might not get to see this one again. But it's, yeah, they gave love to that figure. Dwight was talking about it with, his Asian colleague in an interview. And they were just talking about the complications they had with the footage and the movie and the blah, blah, and the Iron Patriot and all the rest of it. And they just, yeah, they just had decided, nah, screw it. We're just going to make really, really good War Machine figures. So, and they did. They really, really did. Good call. Interesting. That's top 10. I love that. I love doing this stuff. It's like everybody's so wildly different. It's really interesting.
So number five is...
Worthy.
Worthy Captain America.
And he's pretty special, isn't he?
He is. He's great. The head sculpt is good. The blues of the outfit's good. And everything about it works. And then the Steve Rogers head is great as well. After some really shitty Marvel Legends Steve Rogers heads, particularly the Infinity War one. It's kind of like they nailed it, and it's just a great cap. And this is my first non-comic cap kind of thing. So I skipped all the other ones and because I wasn't that impressed with them. So I know that I should have got the Crossbones one. I know that, but I didn't.
It's very similar to this, though, so it's not.
So this one, to me, makes up for not having that one and the difference between those two being the best two. This comes with Thor's hammer, comes with a good weathered shield, and it comes with the two heads where the other head is really good. So he is number five.
Good call.
Number four is, and this is purely my love of, well, actually, it's not. It's a great figure, full stop, but the sentimental value I hold to Nightcrawler.
Nice.
He's so poseable. He's so light. He's everything he needs to be. He's got his sword. He's got the different heads. It's an incredible small figure. And it's, look, it works. And Nightcrawler, X-Men, sure. But for me, Nightcrawler was a part of the Excalibur team. And I don't know why in the 80s I loved Excalibur, but I did.
Yeah, I must admit, again, I'm not a huge X-Men fan. I don't have the love that a lot of people have for it as a kid in the cartoon, but he's definitely in hand. There's that toyetic something about it that just, like the Alex Ross figures, it's just really, really good. And I think it's the addition of the extra heads that make it really interesting to play with and pose and have. The swap out hand, the blade, it works
really well. He's just so poseable. Like, I mean... It all works in whatever pose you put him, and he's really light. The plastic's a different plastic to most of the Marvel Legends figures too. It feels almost rubbery. It's a really great figure, and they nailed it. It's kind of like, that is the version you want. It's not like, oh, they should have done this or they should have done that. It's everything you needed that figure to be, they've done. And, yeah, so number three, I don't have a picture of.
Okay.
And that would be, and I don't own it. Well, I've got him on order, and I guess he's shipping soon, but that's Dr. Doom.
Doom. And I can see why neither of us have him as yet, although he's shipping, about to ship. I mean, it's an update on a previous figure, but boy, is it an update. They've just... yeah, you can even see just in that high res, just the sculpt alone.
And just the detail on all of it, the fabric, the belt, the buckles on the armor, and it's such a beautiful looking figure, and it's great. Like, I mean, I know Doom's Fantastic Four, but strangely, for me as well, Doom was part of, and it's so cool that with Disney Plus that they're all on there so I can watch it again, but Doom was one of Spidey's nemesis in those 80s Spider-Man cartoons and all that stuff, and Secret Wars, and it's like, it's getting the Secret Wars team together, the Marvel Legends of late. So I don't have the old Toy Biz Marvel Legends Doom, so I've got the Iron Man, whatever it was, infamous Iron Man, Doom and all that crap, but that's the Doom I want, and that's the Doom we're getting, and for me, it absolutely nails my Doom. So that's number three. Number two should not be a surprise for me based off different conversations of the show.
Nice.
So I like my Marvel Legends figures. I like them big. I like them chunky. And Wilson this Kingpin is all those things. He's Spidey's foe, he's Daredevil's foe, and this figure just nails it. And
I think the swap out for Rook Head added a whole pile of value as well.
Yeah. And even the fact that we might get a different version of him too, whatever.
Mm.
That'll be good.
He's pretty solid.
So look, he's a chunky figure. He's more poseable than you'd suggest or you'd think.
I agree.
And he looks awesome in photos. The kind of stuff that people do with him is just great.
I agree.
And so he's number two, but I know we said to set a top 10, and my top 10 splits at number one.
Okay.
And there is a clear winner in number one, but it becomes pointless to separate them.
Okay.
And that is to give it a draw.
Nice. Okay.
So this is the real one, but
yep.
Giving it to him, he would still be in the 10 somewhere and it's pointless. So they're just both coming
in as number one. Gotcha.
And I didn't want Grey Hulk to knock out one of those other figures. So they both come in at number one and they are my favorite Marvel Legends. I don't have the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive Hulk.
Yep.
And to be honest, I don't want the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive Hulk. That one does not work for me.
Do it for you.
These two do, but the green one is my favorite. That's number one. Maybe Gray would have sat in at number five or number six or something, but they're both coming together. And again, incredibly poseable, heavy, chunky plastic. Again, I would love a different, even on the Green Hulk, I love this head and it's grown on me. I think there's still a different version of the Green Hulk head that we could get to fit this body perfectly and it'd be even my more ultimate Hulk. But at the end of the day, on paper he looked good, or on screen he looked good. In hand, these figures look incredible, and they've just got so much to them. I love them both. So Green Hulk wins with the purple pants. The plastic and the fabric they use on the shirts is just the greatest soft goods.
It's good at soft goods, but
The interchangeable hands on Green Hulk. It works, and I love it. So he's my number one. And look, my last year's number one was The Thing. So, and Kingpin's number two. This year it's like
chunky
I love my chunky
baths.
Chunky. Yep. So that's it.
That's good. That's solid 10, man. I know you and the kind of the slight skew, slight comic-y, slight kind of, you know, Spidey vibe, and it definitely came through there, but they're still all really good figures. And there was so many. Again, the list before Matt and I did the show, we showed a list of checklist of all the figures released in 2018 exclusives and everything else. My God, there must have been about 60 something figures. I can't remember. I'll never forget when Toy Shiz did a calculation of how much he'd spent on Marvel Legends and Black Series figures for the year as an Instagram pick, and it was something like $4,000 or something. It was just ridiculous amounts of money. But we are toy sleaze bags. This is what we do. My 10 for Marvel Legends, we can skim through some because quite a few you've got are the same for me. Funnily enough, I've got a Hulk that comes in at number 10, but it's not your Hulk. It is a completely different Hulk. It's the Hulk Bath, the Professor Hulk. Now, there were some issues with this one. I did like the hair was a little weird in the side, and they really did a terrible job of painting it. It's just kind of the whole side of the head they painted, and it really didn't work out well. But the sculpt on this figure and the paint, I thought, was superb, and the smirk. And if you pop on the Infinity Gauntlet onto that, as it's kind of intended to for him or Thanos, it just works. So it's a really good figure. I really do like that version of Hulk. I do like the movie figures more than the comic. So that was my number 10. Number 9 was a figure which, again, I just really appreciated the sculpt. And when you got him in hand, just kind of blew me away. And that was Ebony Maw. It was, I don't know if you picked him up, but the face and the design and the height of him, he's such an incredibly long, tall figure. He was really unique and stands very uniquely with all the other figures. The sculpt of it, the soft fabric kind of material, it's not fabric, but it's plastic, that you just mentioned with the Hulk is kind of prevalent on him. The gold and the intricate details and that weird face and huge big hands with rings painted in a lot of detail on every finger were just, again, sculpt. I just thought, wow, this is a really outstanding figure and a very creepy face on him. It looks a lot better in hand than it does there, but yeah, some nice poses with him too. He's just a really interesting figure and quite different, quite unusual.
He definitely was one of my honourable mentions, and he was number 10 for a while, and I knocked him out for Mysterio, which probably again not the right decision, but it's the figure that I really liked, and again
exactly. No, of course, this is their top 10. And talking of that, this was not a particularly good figure, but I always loved the Silver Samurai. I got the 3.75-inch figure frame, got it from me in Nashville many years ago when I lived there, and he picked up the 3.75-inch two-pack for me, and I just fell in love with the Silver Samurai and the story, and then the movie, the Wolverine movie. I love the kind of mech robot, which love Silver Samurai. Slap it on that old Toy Biz card, which is just killer. Had to open the damn thing, but it's still a killer card. Now again, not a particularly great figure. It feels a bit naff in parts and doesn't really work or pose well, but it photographs well and it looks good from a distance. But yeah, Silver Samurai, I was just a fan of it and had to be in my top 10. Look at that photo. So there we go. He was one of my picks. The next one, very quickly, was one you had, which was the Alex Ross Iron Man. God damn, what a figure that is. It's just, it looks so plain and kind of meh, you know, an old-fashioned style Iron Man, boring. You know, we've had quite a few versions of that before, but there's something about it, the way they made it. And again, the pictures just don't do it justice. I've done a review for it. If you don't believe it, watch it and have a look close up at it. But it's a really strong figure. And as Matt said, there's something about this bunch of figures by Alex Ross. They're just really, really good. So
I think for me also, I've been so bored and let down by Marvel Legends Iron Mans for the last 4 years. I think the only one I bought was the last year's 10-year one. Out of all the Iron Mans that had come out, I got the 10 years of Marvel Studios, mm-hmm. that one. And then everything else had just gone, it's always looks shit and cheap and red mm-hmm. plastic and yellow plastic or attempted at gold, everything. Even the Infinity War ones look like shit. I am looking forward. I'm waiting for mine to come through the End Game Iron Man, because that one's looking absolutely sweet as an MCU
it's good.
Iron Man it's suit. Good. But it's why when I saw the real pictures of this or the in-hand one of this, this was just like, oh my God, this is the quality of an Iron Man that has not been around for 3-4 years kind of thing, with the exception of the 10-year special. But it's like, I grabbed that one. But all those Wave Iron Men, even the ones which you like, which I didn't like the extremist one, I just didn't like it. But it wasn't a bad figure. It was a good sculpt and stuff. But even then, the red and gold was not great. It's like this one, they've got the comic red and gold nailed. And on the Endgame one, they've got the cinematic gold and red nailed to look like an SH Figure Arts red and gold kind of thing.
It's, I agree. The paint made a big difference. And it's a big thing on that Alex Ross Iron Man as well. The paint just, something about it just pops. It's really, it's painted well. It's just really well done. So number six, I'm not going to share it again. Kingpin was my number six, the Kingpin Bath, just for all the reasons you said. Really solid. The Farouk head. I'm a huge fan of Legion after the TV show, which I highly recommend to anybody. It is nothing like you will ever see on TV. So a really astounding BAFF was The Kingpin, and that was in at number six. Number five was a Captain America, but not the one you had. And that was the Cap from the Cap and Peggy two-pack. And it just, I just think they absolutely nailed this. Two Steve Rogers heads. Again, they both fit really well with the helmet and just look really good. Knife that was a weathered gun that looked like a real gun. Shield that looked well. Everything about the figure fitted well. The jacket looked good. The shield, the older shield, the Tommy gun for Peggy. Even Peggy was a pretty solid figure, as good as she could be. But he just, something about him just, it really took me back to that first film, and I really liked the design of it, the style of it. It just was that young kind of Steve Rogers from the movie, where he wasn't Cap yet. He was just still kind of learning his way. But really good figure. Definitely recommend you pick it up if you haven't. And it's just, yeah, super solid. Super solid. Okay, that was number five. Number four, also one you had, which was the War Machine Infinity. Just absolutely blew me away. Loved it. Absolutely loved it. So a really solid figure again, sculpt and design. Highly recommend you get it. It would have been lovely to get a little bit more weathering and paint on it, but it's an expensive figure to do because of the brand new sculpt. And a little bit of silver here and there, but yeah, a little bit more weathering would be good. But it's also always something that we can do as fans. We can touch it up to heart's content. But look at that thing. God damn, it's just chunky, funky, awesome. So War Machine, that was Infinity War at number four. Number three for me was yet another movie two-pack. And I've raved at this one before. Scourge and Hela, the two-pack really is outstandingly good. I raved about how Scourge was really one of the best looking head sculpts and figures Marvel had produced. Hela we'd already had in a single release, and with that head it was okay, but these two other heads and the hand that grabs the hammer, I just thought they really nailed it. They got everything right, and they really improved on the previous release of Hela. If you haven't seen that second Hela, she's quite different in paint and design from the first one. Scourge looking just like Carl Urban. The armor was superb. The soft plastic, just look at the detail on the belt. It's really hard to see, but it's a little like wolf, triple wolf design that they had with paint and jewels. It's an outstanding figure. Really, really good. And Hela in the pack, I thought I'd be disappointed by her, but it's Cate Blanchett, and she just, again, everything about it is just really good, really finished. It felt like they'd got a second chance to redo the pack and really think about it, and they really went to town. Rather than just do the same old shit that they did before, they made a lot of mistakes with the paint from Hela and didn't get it quite right. This time round, nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. So a really, really strong contender.
I thought he was going to be your one or two.
What's that?
I thought he was going to be your number one or two.
Oh, really? Well, there you go. He's pretty high up. He's pretty superb. So last two, down to last two, nearly there, folks. Like you, some figures, they might not be the best, but you just can't say no to them and you just love them, and for whatever reason. This figure actually traveled the globe with me this year. The previous version, because this is a repaint and a repack. It's the Marvel Legends Retrowave X-Force Uncanny X-Men Deadpool. I actually prefer the black version of this. There's some slight version differences in here. This is all black in the previous version and slightly different weapons. And I really do prefer that one. But this, on its card, with the paint, the Rob Liefeld design, I think that picture alone got me. That was one of the ones that I just thought it really shows off its posability. It's kind of like Nightcrawler, just really nailed it in a great sculpt and design. So I was really welcome to see it back again. But that pose, that design, that posability on it, and all the weapons he included with it, again, with that card back, is to me probably one of the best Deadpools. And that huge, gorgeous packaging, not only in an inner package, but an outer package as well, I thought was just to be rewarded for maybe $5 or $6 or $5 actually, because it's normally $21.99. For $5 to get the extra card, get the protective box, just to, I mean, both of them are displayable, I thought was just superb. So you can probably guess who my number one is because I just shared it on screen, but it's Iron Patriot. It is, and you've not got this figure yet, but my God, he's awesome. He's just awesome. He's completely different in many, many ways to the Iron Man figure from Infinity War. Lots and lots of different parts, not just a repaint. And he's just superb. The quality of him, again, it's a lot of paint, a lot of silver detail and paint on him. It's a very expensive figure for Hasbro to make. Not only is it large, huge amount of plastic, but there's a lot of fairly intricate paint and transfers. But it just nailed it for me. It's something about, there's a kind of slight metallic shine to the plastic. But a guy had actually, I'd shared a picture on Instagram a while back. A guy had just went around the figure with a little bit of fine tweaks, just a brush here and there, dabbed up a little bit here and there, and added a bit of silver now and again to some things that they missed. Boom, just the best figure of the year for me. Absolutely outstanding. Because I thought this is going to be an SH figure art, sort of a hot toy, because there's a hot toy version of it. And it was the damn Marvel Legends one. So it shows you what you can get for $21.99. So, ta-da! That is Matt and Mai's Marvel Legends Top 10 Figures 2019. That's a lot to go over, but good picks. I think we were really similar on a lot of stuff. There was a lot of figures in there we both had, and I think we both appreciated, which was good both in Star Wars and Marvel.
I think when you look at it in both brands and Hasbro and Star Wars, Marvel and the year in review kind of thing, Star Wars absolutely nailed it when it came to the photo reel, and we've quickly discussed it. But what they are offering now to what was 5 years ago, even 3 years ago, is incredible. And yes, Scourge is an incredible Marvel head, as is Idris Elba's...
Yes,
was just out of my 10 as well. But again, haven't seen him, just going from other people's photos. But Star Wars has nailed photo reel. Marvel is getting it on some figures and missing it on others. They're not as hit, they're more hit and miss now, ironically, than Star Wars is. But they live in the world where comic and movie can almost meld, and it's good. But what Marvel's done, and what they've done with Marvel Legends, which they've nailed and Star Wars definitely hasn't done, is volume this year. The fact is that they have huge volume, and for me, and I'm not as big a Marvel collector, full stop. The only wave I've been able to say no to this year is that, well, in theory, is the Black Widow wave of what's been released and put on a pre-order. I've taken, even on the waves where I haven't participated, I've been able to just maybe pick one or two out of kind of thing. But by no means, they just haven't had many, if any, based on the volume of duds, total swings and misses kind of thing. And they've done that, and I think the only other thing to say about Star Wars on the year in review is what became very apparent when we're doing this list. I think there's only been four waves this year, officially four waves released this year, maybe five. I think it's four. I think it's the Mace wave with Stormtrooper, Mud Trooper Han, and Laura Dern and all that stuff. And then there was the Chopper wave with Dr. Aphra and all that kind of stuff, and Ezra and that. And then there's been the two that just came out. Like, that's the waves this year. There's only been four waves, but there has been a million exclusives. The number of exclusives in Black Series versus regular releases is insane.
On that point, it's insane, absolutely insane. Just that list that we sent you, I stupidly said 60 figures. Wrong. Someone had numbered them in a Facebook group. And we can forget these ones at the bottom of the list because they're kind of head swaps. 157 Marvel Legend figures in 2019 alone. That is a fuck ton of figures. That's a lot. Even if you take 157, I'm going to be very embarrassed here, $22, even without shipping, times 22, you're talking $3,500. It's like Toysha said a while back. $3,500 for Marvel Legends. But yeah, that's the list. That's all of the 2019 figures, which I should give credit to Brian Siegel in the Marvel Legends group, posted from Black Panther to Spider-Man to Captain Marvel to X-Men. But you're right, Star Wars had an infinitesimally small amount compared, probably a fifth of the figures, if you're lucky.
If that. Like, I mean, you're talking about four waves of 6 to 8 figures, because there have been some repacks in those waves. Mm. And then, but you did have a heap of exclusives. Like, I mean, and I'm all for exclusives because they're now more accessible to us. And aside from the ones which are Best Buy or a couple of the Walgreens ones, as opposed to Walmart ones, but the Walgreens ones, they're hard to get internationally, but there's ways of finding them now with Star Actions much better. But the number of them was huge. When I was looking at the top tens, I'm like, exclusive, 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 sure. Exclusive, exclusive. Sure. It's like, what way was, oh, this one was exclusive. But again, fan channel exclusives, Amazon exclusives, the Walmart exclusives have been turning up internationally. Still, strangely, the Walgreens ones tend not to for some reason. I'm not sure.
Yep.
And Best Buy haven't really shown up unless it turned up with other people in America as well, like the Heavy Mando that turned up here. But you throw in the Purge Trooper and everything else. It's just a heap of exclusives this year. And, you know, I guess that's where they're going, and that's fine. But it's a tale of two cities when you look at them. They're two different stories, but they've both got their positives. And really, they don't have too many negatives.
No, but I think I remember going back to February or so, and I think it was you or Scott I was talking to about the... I think it was Scott, just at the point after, or with you and I had the same conversation about that when the figures came out or were announced in Toy Fair, and we kind of were like, oh my God, that's an exclusive, and that's the store, and this store, and that store, and this store. And we were like, how are we going to get all these? And we're both trying to help each other. You get IG-11s, I'll get this, you get this, I'll get that. And it was, it's a full-time global logistics freaking nightmare trying to get Hasbro figures sometimes. Even for people in the US, there's loads of guys I know who will write and send emails to me like, I've got Walmarts and they don't stock this figure, or they won't sell this figure, they won't get this, or Target and they don't get that figure either, or they're scalped. So it's not just international people, it's even lots of people in the States can't find the damn things. So, but it definitely comes to me down to when you look at 160 odd figures for Marvel, 157, there's definitely that huge, and it's become more evident, that huge difference between Marvel and Star Wars about cost. You mentioned it, the comic aspect. It's so, so much cheaper for them to make a figure from a comic base than is the movie base. And that, I think, inhibits Star Wars quite a bit, because they really, as of yet, haven't really pulled upon the comic universe, although they're starting to. Skywalker Strikes, etc. But then that's,
but they're still giving it, they're still giving it
a realistic head,
aren't they? Afro, they're giving it realistic, and even the levels get realistic. So where they can make their savings, they're not, because they're keeping to their mantra of 6-inch style realistic representation of characters.
But I think, as you said, you said this many times before in the show and amongst all the 50 that we've done, and I definitely agree with you, is every couple of waves, just slot in a stormtrooper, slot in some other figure that's in demand. Just give us more of the and the archive is working, but the archive is now on hiatus for a year or so. As we know, there's some other figures coming as they look at the 40th anniversary again. There's a lot of figures that need redone and could be repackaged very easily, and we'd all buy them all again, but definitely complicated with them, with Lucasfilm and Disney and licensing and getting the artist likeness. I think we've talked about this before in the shows, and I'll sum up after this, but NECA, Randy at NECA, is a very good one for talking to people on Twitter about the facial likeness aspect. A lot of people will tweet and say, hey, why can't you do such and such figure? And he says, there's no facial likeness. They won't give the likeness. The actor won't give it away. And it's different with Star Wars films and Marvel films. When they sign up to make the film, you can bet your ass that it's basically, you'll give your likeness away to shampoo bottles. We will sell you till the cows come home. That's part of the deal they get. But with a lot of other figures, it's just, they just can't get the likeness. So,
because I think one of the ones that Randy's spoken about has always been that they can't get Carl Weathers for the Predator because he won't sign it over. But he's an Apollo Creed figure, and he's a well, now he's actually a pop for, which isn't likeness, but he's a pop for the golf one, Billy Madison or Happy Gilmore, kind of thing. But you know, he's a couple of NECA figures on Apollo Creed, but they can't license him for Predator. And I'm pretty sure you'll find they've got that many of the different crew, but they don't have Carl Weathers. Yep. And I've just read a couple of times about it's just we can't afford to license it, or it's too much kind of thing. Mm. But yeah, ironically, there he is as Apollo Creed. So just take one of those heads and.
It's over across. See if you'll notice.
Yeah.
We've covered a lot of ground here tonight, and we're not cheating you out of Matt's Toy Photography. Again, definitely follow and join this man. He has a lot of good stuff on his page. But we're going to dedicate the next show, episode 51, all to the best Marvel and Star Wars toy photography. So in the meantime, you can head to Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries and join the other 117,000 people in appreciating the love of the Black Series figures. And some of the ones we've talked about tonight will be Ray, that Matt likes the Mando, your Baby Yoda, all sorts of cool new stuff is on that page. So, yes. What's 117?
117,000 followers.
Ah, gotcha. There you go. So there's that and Toy Tribe. Join them both. And again, what we'll do in between, maybe before or after your Christmas, we shall, Matt and I will go over some of the best toy photography, your best toy photography that you've liked in 2019, and highlight some of the cool creatures and artists out there. Did we miss anything else you want to talk about?
No, I'm just going to go to bed and watch.
That top 10 took a lot of me. It's like, well, there's a lot going on in that top 10. Thank you to everybody who watched. Kenny Creeley, Darth Emmett, Shakes the Clown, all you guys that always regularly comment. What's up, Chief? Everybody that's on there. I'm forgetting all the names. But anyway, thank you, everybody who watches. Give it a thumbs up if you like it and hit subscribe or tell your friends about it. We'd appreciate it. And roll on episode 51. We'll see you then. Cheers.
Bye.